These are the oil fields of West Texas. 2 miles beneath the dust and rattlesnakes lies a buried treasure that men are willing to risk their lives to get. 100% Texas crude.
He's got a blow!
This is the ultimate race to strike it rich. And modern-day cowboys are willing to dig deep.
Gotta keep it drilling, rain or shine, man!
Just for a taste.
Oh, man, I live for this.
Of black gold.
It's 1 week into the race to hit oil, and already each rig is struggling. At the brand new Viking rig, nice guy Wayne and his crew thought the new rig would be an advantage.
It's a roughneck Christmas out here.
But they've been dogged by mechanical problems that have put them over budget and in last place for oil.
Something so small can have such a big impact.
On the 64-year-old Longhorn, no-nonsense driller Gerald has the old rig running smoothly and well in the lead.
Let's go!
But Peanut, the rookie roughneck, or worm, barely survived a life-threatening accident. And then went MIA.
Get your damn ass dressed, boy! We're supposed to be there at 5:30 this morning!
Over at the Big Dog rig, driller Tim got drunk, got nasty.
I'll whoop your damn ass, motherfucker!
And after failing to show up for work, got fired.
Good hand's a good hand, but a hand that ain't here ain't worth the f***.
New driller Justin stepped in to get the Big Dog back on track. It's a wake-up call for his crew.
You want to learn how to be a f***ing derrick, man, you pay attention, you hear me?
Coming down.
At the old Longhorn rig, driller Gerald and his crew are already 6,000 feet into the ground.
Push, we not push.
They're more than halfway to their goal, hitting the pay zone. Pushing the rig this hard means extra wear and tear. One loose bolt can stop progress, injuring or killing a roughneck if it drops from the derrick. The upkeep itself is a dangerous job, but it must be done every single day.
They check all of our motors and all the gearboxes and grease zerts and things to make sure the rig's being maintenance right.
All right, check them pumps, KRMs and motors.
And they'll go from the top of the rig, which is called the crown, from the crown to the ground. I mean, they check everything in between.
The crew member responsible for the upkeep is called the derrick man. He has to climb a terrifying 12 stories every morning before 9 a.m.
Going up to the crown is kind of scary.
The West Texas winds can rock the rig up to 5 feet in each direction.
The ladder ain't always sturdy. Oh, there's a bunch of little things that could go wrong.
A long ways up, but it takes a tough individual to be a rough neck. A lot of people think, oh, anybody can do it. Well, anybody wants to try it, welcome to come on down. We'll give them a shot.
Gerald knows the dangers on a rig firsthand.
I fell out of the derrick, busted my back up, fell 63 feet. It was icy, and as I stepped out like that, that foot went out from under me. When it did, I just went right over backwards. Ricocheted off all that iron up and down through that derrick. Hey, that's what saved my ass, though. Was hitting that iron. If I'd have just fell straight and hit that floor, it would have killed me.
Surviving the big fall earned him a spot in the legendary 16 Club.
There's 16 members in it, and there are 16 people that fell out of derricks and lived to tell about it. It's kind of a small club. It's one you don't try to get into. That's damn sure. You try to stay away from that one, but it happens.
It's a new day and a new crew for the giant Big Dog rig. Despite the overhaul, Justin's managed to whip his new team into shape and has them at a depth of 5,600 feet, only 400 feet behind the Longhorn.
Driller's responsibility is everything. I mean, from drilling the hole, making sure you've got fluid in your pits, making sure everybody's doing their job, really everything as far as the driller.
He's pushing hard and keeping a close eye on the only holdover from Big Dog's first crew, his worm, Derek.
Walk it up.
Walk it up, let me throw it.
Walk it up.
Oh, damn. It's
our worm chain hand, don't know how to throw the chain.
Shut the f*** up.
There you go, that a girl.
The Roughnecks have a lot to handle.
Wait on you, girl.
And for Derek, that includes getting used to the new boss.
He sees you talking. What are you talking for? What are you doing? What are you working on? This is gonna line you out. Quit talking and do your job, son.
What?
I said, quit talking and do your job. If you're not feeling good, be nice to work for Tim, you know, because you can hide out. He's not, you know. You're not gonna get much rest with Justin.
Hey! Take all these tools out.
When I tell you I want you to do it like that, that's how I want you to do it, okay? All right? Sound like a good deal?
Good deal.
All right.
I want you to wear your face shield, okay?
For what?
Huh?
For what?
Because I said, safety. Yeah.
Clean
them sacks up. Just mash them together and set them somewhere nice and neat. Keep count of them. We'll throw them away later.
I gotta put together sacks nice and neat. Not because there's a reason, just because the boss said. That's the way he said it. Not very nice.
One thing's already clear. Derek needs to make changes or he's not gonna make it on Justin's crew. The brand new Viking rig is off to a rough start. Wayne and his crew are well behind their rivals.
Pick him up.
The temperature is rising, but they're finally starting to gain some ground.
It's a hot sun bitch out here, man. Yeah, it ain't bothering none of us. We're all used to this.
It's not the only thing the Viking crew has gotten used to.
Yeah, that's the number two motor flush right there.
Yeah, Steven.
Not good.
One of the motor clutch bolts has come loose, causing a burnout. This is the second time they've had trouble with this clutch since the rig came out of the yard.
This might set us back more than a day right here.
It costs about $45,000 a day to run a drilling rig and its crew. So every minute lost is money down the drain.
Yeah, another little surprise there. But if you got some any clutches and motors, you know, something can go wrong at any time.
With ground to make up on the other two rigs, this setback is the last thing the Viking needs. Back at the Longhorn rig, driller Gerald's got problems of his own.
Peanut, get on the damn phone and call me, you little worm. Get on the phone, get your ass in this rig.
The Longhorn crew is one man short. The rig's worm, Peanut, is a no-show again. A driller is only as strong as his weakest hand, and Gerald's not quick to forget.
I don't want to lose Peanut. I've invested a lot of time in Peanut. I really like the young man, but the best man in the world ain't worth a damn if he ain't here. And he ain't here. Pick him up, Paul. Pick him up on that telephone. Tied him up. Let's go to work.
No worm means more work for the other Roughnecks, and they're getting sick of it.
Peanut twisted off again, man. I hope he don't come back. Surely that driller won't let him come back, man. That's twice in a week. Less than a week. It ain't been, you know what I mean? That guy.
Gerald may like Peanut, but he knows in the oil field, every man's expected to pull his weight.
They don't get to take his paycheck, split it between the two of them, and they're doing his work, so that won't fly.
If it was me, I mean, I hate to say it, but I'd run his ass off. I would, because I'm not gonna make my other hand suffer. And that's not because I'm a prick, it's just how it is. Not everybody can be a roughneck.
When the work gets harder, it gets more dangerous. But with only 9 days left to drill this hole, staying safe takes a back seat to picking up peanut slack.
Can't be letting them tongs come on latch, guys. They'll get somebody hurt.
The Longhorn still got a slim lead over the other rigs, but with a hole to drill and oil to find, Peanut better pray he still has a job. Coming up,
I'm gonna push your ass out that door.
The Longhorn Worm finally shows up, but is it too little too late?
Yeah, unfortunately for Peanut, he's probably gonna be replaced.
And the Big Dog hits a problem that could put them out of the race for good.
It's what we call a whale from hell.
Over at the Viking, driller Wayne's motor clutch was fixed overnight. But that was just the latest in a run of troubles for the new rig.
He's got a blow!
Plus, he's got a supervisor breathing down his neck.
All you gotta do is help me and I'll do it.
In the race for oil, they're dead last. But Junior thinks he might have figured out the reason for their problem.
You might get to believe this. Texas flag is upside down.
I'm gonna go get Steve and we're gonna fix that right quick.
The oil field is a superstitious place. And messing with the Texas flag is asking for trouble.
We're gonna fix whoever made this big mistake. Down here, everybody knows why it's on top, man. Pretty proud of our state and where we come from. Now that kind of makes us all look like a bunch of idiots.
What the ball-headed hell's going on out here?
Look at the Texas flag.
I mean, if that's a disgrace to the oil field. Hot doggy.
That's the way it's supposed to look right there, people.
That's beautiful.
With the Lone Star upright and flying proud, things at the Viking are starting to turn around.
Yeah, it's our first trouble-free day of drilling. Hopefully it'll stay like that. Everybody cross their fingers. It's kind of nice to get out here and everything's running real smooth there. Looks like we finally got all the kinks worked out of it.
That's more like it, Steve.
They've been getting 60 feet of pipe an hour into the ground. That's twice as fast as the normal pace and the kind of progress that leads to big cash fast.
Use a little more cloud cover. It's hot as hell, but today's a great day, man. Sweat that beer out. Get back to work.
But things have slowed to a crawl on the Longhorn. With Peanut, the crew worm, as a no-show, Gerald's team has been doing double the work and getting half the results.
Get her back up.
They're at 6,400 feet, but have only put in two pieces of pipe since morning.
Yeah, unfortunately for Peanut, he's probably gonna be replaced. Peanut finally showed up about 8:15 this morning. He's, supposed to have been here at 5:30, so it's about 2 hours, 45 minutes late again.
I ain't a morning person. I like getting up at 4:30 in the morning. I'm pretty sure nobody does.
I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning to go to work. Everybody else should, too. Peanut walked by there. He didn't even look up in my direction. He just totally looked the other way. So he knows what's up. He knows what time it is.
After I got off work yesterday, I went to the doctor with my wife, and they told us that we're having a boy. So I got excited, and I drank a little bit too much last night. Sorry, but I'll come talk to you in a minute.
You're having a little boy? Good.
Excited.
What I want to know is how you going to feed him.
I work.
Huh?
Work.
You're going to work?
Yep.
Hell, you can't get there on time. What do you mean you're going to work?
Oh, yeah. It's got a boy coming.
work though, you know?
You know, excuses are kind of like everybody's got one, they all stink.
Gerald's a tough driller to work for, and now he's got a tough decision.
I just hate to run his ass off knowing that baby's coming. Roll it in there. There you go. He's had a rough life. I'm trying to give him a break. I'll probably give him too many breaks. Most people wouldn't give him near that many chances. If you want a job to feed that kid, you better be here every day. You late one more time, I'm putting your ass out that door. You understand that? Late one more time. I don't give a for what reason. You're fired. Is that cool? Don't be late. Get out of here.
I gotta mature more. I can't always want to be partying or be young no more. I gotta be an adult now, you know. I'm gonna have a child on the way. And I gotta take more responsibilities now. I gotta go.
The giant big dog rig is coming on strong. New driller Justin and his roughnecks have had two solid days of drilling and gotten 30 pieces of pipe into the ground.
Everything's looking good so far. I haven't tagged anything coming down.
At a depth of 6,500 feet, they're a close second to Longhorn and gaining. Even Worm Derek is giving his all.
Put her in the hole, baby.
Dead center.
They're putting pipe in the ground fast, but the good times don't last long.
Swelling up on us, could be our hole caving in, or it could just be a little bridge or something that's in our way.
The big dog rig is stuck. They've drilled into a new formation of earth. Now the ground is caving in on the drill bit and stopping it from turning. Everyone hits the deck while Justin tries to get big dog back in action. No drilling means no money.
I'm trying to pump it down right now, get whatever's in our way washed up aside.
They've been down 2 hours. That's thousands of dollars lost.
You know, you shut down like this, it costs your company money, it costs your oil company money, and it really pisses them off. It's setting us back on time and money, definitely.
Let's see that pump pressure. Get out of the way so I can see that pump pressure.
Drilling mud should circulate from these reservoirs into the drill pipe and down through the drill bit to keep the hole clean of debris. They're trying to use extra mud to wash out the well, and it's creating intense pressure. If they don't get Big Dog moving, the rig could blow.
We gotta keep a close eye on our pressure gauge here, make sure we don't get too much pressure, folks. Blow one of these hoses off.
The hoses that carry the drilling mud can explode at any minute with enough force to rip a man's leg off. And things downhole are getting worse. They've gone from being stuck in one place to actually losing ground.
I think our hole is starting to cave in on us, actually. The more we pick it up, try to come back down, it's like our hole is caving in, and we just get stuck in the same spot, or we start losing progress rather than making progress.
Big Dog was at 6,500 feet when they got stuck. They've lost 500 feet and are back to 6,000. That's an entire day of drilling and $45,000 gone. If they don't get this under control and fast, they could lose the entire well and over $1 million.
Some wells you can drill are just a nightmare. It's what we call a well from hell. And it starts from the beginning of the well to the end of the well. It's nothing but a nightmare. Everything you do up. Everything you touch up. The whole up. But you get these problems like this, it's costing a lot of money and a lot of time, and there's a lot of people that are getting very, very hot.
Coming up, the big dog rig battles to save their well.
We might have even more worse problems than we bargained for.
And later on the Viking, driller Wayne's done listening to his boss.
If the toe pusher don't like it, he can my
oil man Mike LaMonica and his company EXL Petroleum have a lot at stake. They're backing both the Viking and the Longhorn rigs. It's a multi-million dollar gamble that could go bust at any time.
This is the biggest risk right here, being able to get the well drilled.
Solomonica takes a hands-on approach. He and partner Doug Robison have driven out from Midland to check up on the Viking rig.
On this rig, we had 3 hours of downtime. This is a brand new rig.
Just came out of the yard,
so a lot of things can happen on a brand new rig.
It's several thousand dollars a day to run this rig, so when they break down, it costs me money.
Just hoping everything turns out good. It all boils down to the guys that came to work for us.
LaMonica and Robison want to check in with a man at the controls.
How do you like this rig?
It's got a lot of quirks to it right now. We had help getting started there. It seemed like everything pretty well worked out. I think we'll have a lot better load than we.
When you have experienced people on here, you have fewer people hurt, equipment not lost, and so it was really good to see Wayne.
Got to see this white hair.
So he's got gray hair.
How old are you?
44 years old.
Well, that's more experience than just about everybody out here, isn't it?
Yeah, I've been working out here in the field for 27 years now.
We're going to be paying attention to every bit of our equipment in the car,
every
right?
Bit of
just like it's your own, right?
Just like it's my own.
After being reassured by Wayne, Mike moves on to a Texas-style business meeting, hunting dove with pipe salesman Rooster McConaughey.
You can shoot a catfish or you can shoot at the doggone bird. Right there.
To your left.
Shoot at him again. You scared him.
Rooster supplies Mike with all the pipe that goes into his wells. And out here, they make multi-million dollar deals with a handshake.
Rooster and I started together in 1989 when he did all in used pipe.
We
ordered $3,640,000 worth of pipe.
Damn sure did.
And you trust him, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
I mean, what an idiot. I didn't have any money.
I mean, I did. Well, neither one of us had it money.
Well, I gotta take it off the same tee.
I'm glad you can hit oil wells better than you can hit birds.
The giant big dog rig started the day off at 6,500 feet, but the well from hell is collapsing in the hole and has them going backwards. They've lost 500 feet and are back to 6,000.
We might have even more worse problems than we bargained for.
Brian is working in the mud pits to clear the blockage, but isn't having any luck.
It's got a lot of lost circulation material in it, which caused not to flow, so. If they don't keep an eye out, it gets clogged up. So I've gone about as far as I can go. It's up to that driller now.
The pressure is continuing to build in the hoses and on the rig. Worm Roughneck Derek is testing his driller's patience.
I want you to stay by that 2-inch one.
Which one? Right over there.
Right over there. That's that first one the whole time. Don't move from it. Your job is to stand right by that 2-inch. When I tell you to open it, then you open it.
How's that going to help?
How's that going to help? Well, it'll help from blowing these hoses off and blowing these guys off the big floor and blowing you up off the side of the clubhouse.
There's nothing wrong with asking questions, but Derek needs to learn that in a dangerous situation, it's time to shut up and do what he's told.
I can questionize, motherfucker. I can get pissed off, I have so many questions.
The hole's going bad, and the pipes aren't the only thing ready to blow. Justin is trying to manage a critical problem, and his rookie doesn't know the danger he's in. These roughnecks will work into the night, trying to get the dog back into the hunt. And Big Dog's not the only one stuck in the mud. At the Longhorn, driller Gerald finally has his full crew. But two-thirds of the way to total depth, the drill bit is stuck.
Today we're not making nothing, so we'll get out there and tackle it and see if we can't get it beat today so we can get back to drilling. Being stuck can last from 30 minutes to 30 days.
Like the Big Dog, the Longhorn is stuck. But the problem is very different. The 64-year-old rig has drilled a crooked hole, and the pipe is caught. caught up in three places. It's a common but potentially disastrous problem.
Very frustrating. Very frustrating. When you can't get things done, things are not working for you. It just really frustrates hell out of you.
Doesn't do you any good to dig a hole, dig it so damn crooked you can't get pipe in it.
They only have 2 weeks to drill this well. A hole problem puts everything at risk and could mean millions of dollars lost. If they can't get the bit loose, they'll have to cement this well shut and start all over again. Gerald knows there's only one way to get this drill moving, using sheer force.
Kelly Driver is about 5,000 pounds of iron welded together. If we pick up and we drop it, just like a hammer, once we get it moving up and down that hole, then we can get somewhere. This ain't gonna be no easy task.
But it's a dangerous strategy. The slightest problem can lead to disaster. It takes years of experience to handle this kind of power. So Gerald decides to attach it himself.
Right there.
Above that floor, it's dangerous. There's no way to get any leverage. It ain't no picnic up there, that's for damn sure.
Coming down a little bit. Whoa.
Slamming the Kelly Driver puts everyone in danger. It's like dropping a pickup truck onto the rig floor. Gerald makes sure his guys are out of the way before the 2.5 tons of steel comes crashing down.
You pick it up and you drop it. It's gonna make a lot of noise. And you will probably feel it standing here on the ground.
Gerald knows with that much force, the smallest thing can be a real danger.
Last time we were doing this, we had a lot of cottonseed hulls in our mud and on that flat surface where that thing lands. When I got home that evening, a lady friend of mine had to take a pair of tweezers and pick that cottonseed out of my skin where that hammer hit it and it shot out and embedded into my face.
Being stuck is a tough break for Gerald's Longhorn crew, but it's good news for the Roughnecks at Viking.
Look over there across the field, old Longhorn's down. And everybody gets a little bad luck every now and then. But it's a good chance for us to catch back up, maybe TD this hole before they do.
Coming up, Justin puts his life on the line to get Big Dog back in the race. And one of the rigs might get shut down.
We have to watch our speed because we will run out of money.
At the giant Big Dog rig, the well from hell has cost them 500 feet of progress, and they've been down for 24 hours. That's $45,000 gone. Even worse, they've fallen 800 feet behind the other rigs. Justin thinks they've solved their problem.
Good clean holes, the happy holes.
They've flushed the well to clear away the collapsed section. Now they test the hole to make sure.
I'll come down and see if I tag anything. Nice and slow. As far as I can tell, from me just picking, working my pipe right there, the hole looks pretty clean.
A clean hole is a green light to get working and back in the race to hit oil.
That's how the real fun gets to happen.
Before they can get back to drilling, more than a mile of pipe that was pulled out has to go back in. And there's more bad news. Justin is a man short. He'll have to pick up the slack. Today, he'll be working a precarious 90 feet above the rig floor to control every strand of pipe as it goes back in. The old bit, which is attached to the bottom pipe, still has some life in it. It's $60,000 of steel, tungsten, and diamond. It'll get used till it's done in. Then the pipe and bit go back in the hole and lock in place.
You going in?
Yeah, we in.
With so many setbacks, the pressure's on to get more than 100,000 pounds of steel into the ground so they can get back to drilling and start making up for lost time and lost money. But doing it safely is a tall order for a short-handed crew. Justin has to lock in each piece of loose pipe if his safety gear can hold him.
Watch your fingers.
The big dog has some catching up to do. They're finally digging again on the well from hell. Back in Midland, Mike LaMonica and his company, EXL Petroleum, are hoping to cash in on the oil boom.
Gilligan, you want to give us an update on each one of the rigs?
Viking 2.
When do you think you'll TD?
It's just hard to say when they're going to get done. It's going to jack our prices up.
The Viking rig has gotten off to a slow start and is already behind schedule. And today, the old Longhorn is stuck and hasn't made any progress. EXL put up more than $1 million to get the rights to drill these wells, and it's costing them $4,000 more every hour to run the rigs. They have to hold the line on costs.
You look at the pace you've got moving. We're drilling. It's $14 million a month we're spending on drilling and completion.
We have to watch our speed because we will run out of money.
EXL's a small company. Big costs could mean big trouble.
We just need to watch this one real close and decide whether we want to keep them or not.
If oil doesn't start flowing soon, one of the rigs will be shut down. With the Longhorn and Big Dog struggling, spirits among Wayne and the Viking Roughnecks are high.
That's basically the way we kick ass out here.
You know better than this,
though. Hell no, man. I live for this.
Viking's been working at a breakneck speed. At a depth of 6,800 feet, they've pulled past Big Dog. Wayne and his crew are ready to hand the rig off to the graveyard shift. But the graveyard shift is nowhere to be seen.
I just talked to the tool pusher. They said that they want us to double tonight.
I thought you were going to tell me something important.
Something different.
Something we don't know.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's what he said. The bad news is that's going to make us all have to stay out here.
The bad news is that's going to get more hours on our paycheck.
There's no time for an idle rig. If one crew doesn't show up, another has to stay. But Wayne's boys are up to the challenge.
41 hours in 3 days. That's going to make for a hell of a paycheck, man. Strong money.
Everybody took it real well. I'm proud of these guys for not throwing a fit up. Myself, I want to lay down in the floor and throw a fit. Do the curly shuffle or something.
They just got 8 more hours of hot, dirty work. But what they don't know, Mother Nature is about to join the race. Coming up, oil and water don't mix. And chaos strikes when a driller disappears.
It's gonna be too hard to ask somebody to do their job on the floor.
At the old Longhorn rig, it's been 10 long hours of constant hammering on the drill bit. They've been stuck at 7,200 feet, making no progress and no money.
We might get it done in 30 minutes. It might be 30 days, guys. Nobody knows till we get it out.
The stuck bit has already cost the Longhorn team half a day of drilling and nearly $25,000. Just when things seem hopeless, After hours of grueling work, they get the bit moving and get to call it a day.
I'm looking forward to getting out of these sweaty, nasty clothes, getting off this location, getting as far away from this as I can get for a day, at least one day.
At the Big Dog, Justin and his men are still putting pipe back in. They've fallen behind and will stay until the job's done. The lost hole has taken them off schedule and over budget. Now they've got a storm to deal with.
Child's play. We working that, it don't matter. Lightning, thunder, rain, snow, we working it. Suffer, that's why you make the good money.
This makes it a little bit more dangerous. Things are a little bit more slick when it rains.
This is what we call Thunderdome up here.
But Justin will do whatever it takes to get Big Dog back in the race. While Justin's hanging 90 feet in the air to keep Big Dog moving, at the Viking, the crew's pulling a rainy double, but Wayne is nowhere to be found, and it's not 5 minutes before there's a problem. The daylight crew failed to keep the machines oiled, so now Steve has to pull their weight in the middle of a downpour.
It's gonna be too hard to ask somebody to do their job. I'll do it more. Whoop somebody's ass.
Usually the rig supervisor, known as the tool pusher, would stay in his trailer during a storm.
It's funny, man.
But tonight, the boss is on the rig floor, and he's angry that Wayne is missing. But Wayne had his reasons for leaving.
I went and got some food and stuff for the guys there, because we're working a double. And if the tool pusher don't like it, he can my Yeah, look at that, huh?
That's all I want right there.
Once his boys are fed and dry, Wayne jumps right back to the controls.
I went and got these guys some food, man.
I got her.
Awesome. Not a lot of drillers would do that for you.
I want to make sure they had something to eat and that.
That's what makes my driller a good driller to be with, because it's just, that's the way it is. If you take care of your hands will take care of you.
Yeah, back to business as usual there.
Coming up, the Viking crew has a big day out.
Beer and guns.
While the smallest Longhorn makes a huge mistake. The men of the Viking have been pushing themselves and their new rig to get back on schedule and find oil.
Today's almost over with. About made it. Only got like 3 more hours to go. And I go home and relax because I doubled last night for 16 hours. And I'm just ready to get the hell out of here.
They're only 2,000 feet from total depth. And they've got a much-needed day off while the relief crew covers the rig.
Hey, man, we'll get lucky again and find another rattlesnake.
Wayne and his crew are more than just hired hands. They're a roughneck family. And these boys are ready to blow off steam together.
Beer and guns.
Cool. Texas style.
Bam! Oh! Yeah!
Boom.
Holy
yeah.
Cool.
Wow! Mother dude.
There he is right there. Got him. I got him by the tail.
Hey,
I got him.
Get away.
I got him by the tail, Dad. I got the tail in. I don't got the head in.
Yeah, that's not the right end to get, Steve.
Well, they told us something about not doing this at school.
All right, one time, baby. Come on.
Holy that hurt.
Holy
that's
you gotta be strong and hold tight.
Holy
strong, buddy.
Oh, y'all. Oh, man. Oh, man.
I don't want to play no more.
This is great, right? Don't get no better than this. Death and destruction and the rainbow.
At the veteran Longhorn rig, driller Gerald's crew has hit their stride. They lost a day of drilling when the rig got stuck, but have been making up for it this morning. They got lucky and hit a soft ground formation, making the drilling fast and furious. They're well in the lead at 8,200 feet. While Gerald takes a minute to show Henry some tips of the trade.
You don't get that slide up off the ground, it's just gonna keep doing that.
Inexperienced roughnecks Paul and Peanut are left unsupervised to do some dangerous lifting. Got lazy and tried to haul four pipes on a safety line designed to handle only three. Gerald turned his back for a moment, and the result was a near disaster.
Did something up too much pipe at one time, got it all crazy, crossed up out there. I'm gonna kill everybody big enough to die. Bring your ass up here! The way they had that chain tied on the end of that pipe, that chain could have slipped off, just like you seen me knock it off there with that hammer. It could have slipped off there on its own very easy, and that pipe would have fell down. Not one joint, but four joints of pipe. And you got people all around, so if four joints of pipe come falling out of the sky, it's gonna hit somebody, chances are.
Because you see what just happened right there? That could have got your dumb ass killed.
That was kind of scary. That falls, it was going towards me because it's gonna fall straight down.
No more pipe was out the safety line. There is a chain down there. It's got an eye on it. It's got three chains. It's got loops on the end of it. Get it right. Don't never let me see you pick up another piece of pipe without using it. Now get down there and get it. Let's get this picked up.
Peanut was down there on the ground, let it get away from him, fell off the catwalk. Ended up against the side of the sub. I mean, we up, should have used that safety chain.
Gerald's given Peanut plenty of breaks, but he draws the line when it comes to safety.
I think I've got him on it. I'm going to ride him up for it, and then we'll go from there. But I don't think they'll make that mistake anymore.
Between bad attendance and bad choices, Peanut is on thin ice.
When you get in a hurry, people are going to get hurt. You can pretty well count on that. So just take your time, make sure what you're doing, do it right, do it safe. And make sure nobody gets hurt. We're not in that big of a hurry. We've always got tomorrow. I can replace 12 hours of time a lot quicker than I can replace a man's life.
Next time on Black Gold.
Yes, God Almighty.
On the Viking rig.
Come on, back, dude. I'm here.
An injury may cost one of Wayne's roughnecks his job.
I'm gonna run that ass off.
The Big Dog crew enjoys a day off.
Nowhere.
And at Longhorn, Gerald's had it with his crew.
Chain these son of a bitches off and get them out of my way. I don't care if you get them out.